Welcome to the Playthrough Show. Today we are playing the second game on the Nathan Drake Collection, which is Uncharted 2 Among Thieves Remastered. There's going to be another menu here in just a minute. Hold on. On the other side of this loading screen, there's going to be a menu. Here we go. This is where the game actually starts.
I do wonder what that weird toothpick has to do with anything.
I don't think it's a toothpick. I think it's a knife.
Or it's a knife. Toothpick, knife, whatever. Same thing.
Yeah. Completely interchangeable. We are not in this for continuous speed runs. We are in this for campaigns. And...
normal.
You sure you don't want to go straight for crushing?
No. Normal.
And the adventure will begin after another brief visit from our friend, the toothpick.
Oh, he's gone and crashed again.
What's going on?
Oh.
Yeah, he's...
that's my blood.
...somewhat injured.
It's a lot of my blood.
Just throw you right in there.
A rock and a hard place. Okay, I've identified the rock, and I'm assuming the hard place is right below me. Oh. You know, I guess if you had to climb up the underside of a train... I wonder how long we're going to have to play before we find out why he's doing it. And also what he's doing on the train. Just because it's pretty obvious that something's gone very, very wrong.
It's okay.
Yeah, you'll be safe inside of the train.
Right? Which you were trying to get off of, yes.
Oh. Okay. I'm glad it didn't kill me.
Come on.
not sure what it... There he is. And now let's just run as quickly as possible through this train. I don't want us to be falling off of any more cliffs.
Oh, come on, Drake.
See? He's perfectly fine. You'd be drinking too if you just survived that.
Buy me a drink, sailor.
Oh my.
Hey! What the hell are you doing here?
I'm looking for you, mate.
Uh-oh. Should I be flattered or worried?
Maybe a bit of both. Come here. I've got a job for us.
Really?
A client is willing to part with a huge sum of cash if we acquire a certain object for him.
Right, I'm listening.
Now, you're not gonna like this.
Oh, no. No, you're out of your mind.
Yeah, you just hear me out for a second.
Flynn, we both know two people who were killed trying to lift something out of this
and
place.
And one who made it out.
Yeah, barely.
I can't do this without you, Drake. You're the only one who's cracked it, and you know better than anyone it's a two-person job.
No. Three, actually.
Right. And speak of the devil, here she comes now.
Here's his new lady friend for this game.
Nate. Drake. Nathan. Drake.
Hello, Harry.
Chloe here's one of the best drivers in the business. She'll take good care of us.
I bet.
Right, look.
She's gonna betray you the first second she gets a chance to.
Go in through...
You're sure it's not gonna be Harry?
So far.
That puts us in the courtyard. From there, we scale up the wall, run across the rooftops, and just drop...
He does have a trustworthy accent.
Bob's your uncle. And what is worth all this trouble, I hear you ask?
I didn't, but go ahead. But that's it. An oil lamp.
Yeah.
It's worthless. I don't get it.
Neither do we. That's why we tracked you down.
Well, it sounds like you're working for a nutcase. Some collector who's got too much time and money on his hands. And by the way, this is not worth any of it.
But there's more. How's your 13th century Latin, mate?
Where'd you get this?
Borrowed it. From the files of the nutcase.
In Trebizond, we were set upon by thieves. Father, Maffeo, and I were robbed of our greatest treasures. This was written by Marco Polo.
Yes, that much we were able to work out.
Unfortunately, the rest of it's nonsense.
Hey, hold on. So that it should not fall into the wrong hands, I concealed my great sorrow in the unlikeliest place. The light of the great Khan shelters the fate of the 13.
See what I mean? It's just gibberish.
He's talking about the lost fleet.
Yeah.
I know. Someone want to fill me in?
Marco Polo leaves China with 600 passengers and 14 ships loaded down with treasure from Kublai Khan. And he lands in Persia a year and a half later with only one ship left and only 18 passengers. Now, he recorded every detail of his journey, but he never told what happened to all those ships and the passengers.
So somewhere out there, there are 13 ships loaded with the Emperor's treasure waiting to be found.
Yeah, and that is what your client is after. Hey, look at this lamp. It's covered in Mongolian script. It must have been a gift from Kublai Khan.
The light of the great Khan shelters the fate of the 13.
Marco Polo hid something inside this lamp. Something that pinpoints the site of the lost fleet.
So, we're dicking this guy over, right?
Damn straight.
Absolutely. You in then?
In steps the main bad guy of the game.
Yeah, I'm not sure if this is a good people or a bad people thing to do, given that they're probably dealing with a criminal, but at the same time... Ah, there's a treasure over there. I can already see it. The other side of those rocks.
Hope there wasn't one on the train.
Wrathful deity statue. Well, that's a good sign. Hey, look. He drags... Okay, I thought he was gonna kick chunks with him out onto the road. He seems like he's in pretty rough shape. It's probably not very nice of us to be forcing him to look for treasure, so we will get out of the snow and into the warm wreckage.
Like oil.
I wouldn't be surprised if it was. Wasn't. Would be surprised if it wasn't, given crash train. Probably full of it. Saraswati. I'm not sure what that is. We will protect you from the weather by going inside of this car.
Locked. It's always locked. He's alive! Karma's a bitch.
You would think at this point he would have had enough of precariously balanced train cars, but apparently not.
Ouch.
Ah, he was already injured.
That's gotta hurt. Oh.
He spent his entire career training for this moment. We're going to get another flashback to a sunny beach.
Hello. Well, so much for foreplay.
You mind telling me what the hell is going on?
You mean with Flynn?
Yeah, you might have warned me.
And missed the look on your face? Anyway, you haven't exactly made yourself easy to find.
Talk about making yourself easy.
Oh, you're not jealous. Let's not forget who walked out on whom. After all, you don't get to be jealous.
Wait a minute, Chloe.
If it makes you feel any better, my relationship with Flynn is strictly professional.
Really?
Mostly professional.
Oh.
When I figured out he was actually onto something, I thought you'd want to be in on the action.
So what's the plan?
Just like we said. We pull the heist, we find the ships, and we make off with the treasure.
With Flynn?
Mm-hmm.
And then?
And then we split the take three ways, and you and I just disappear. Together, this time.
I see.
Until then, he can't know about us.
He's gonna be pissed.
He's gonna be fine. Trust me.
Somebody is betraying somebody. And it looks like it goes deeper than we thought.
And somehow he's still alive.
There we go. Laid there just long enough to have a flashback. And now he's better. Oh, look at that blood pool. I put that there.
Oh, come on.
Yeah, he's in great shape for a death-defying leap. Let's do it. Hey, but look, I still have my gun. So, it's not all bad.
He probably deserves this for screwing over his friend.
And their client, whoever he was. Hey, look, a toothpick.
Sure you're up for this. Feel a lot better if I had a gun. We won't need them. A little insurance, that's all. Flynn, they're just museum guards. And we have their patrols all mapped out. Relax.
Relax? Relax. Have you ever been in a Turkish prison, mate? If we get caught, they will lock us up and throw away the sodding key. You do realize that, don't you?
Better than you do.
Well, you may fancy that kind of thing, but I don't. Can't afford to make any mistakes.
Yeah, and we won't.
We're here.
This way. So what do we do if they switch the patrols?
Figure it out as we go.
We cannot fumble our way through this.
I don't fumble. I improvise.
Oh, is that what you call it?
Yeah. I'm, adaptable.
Adaptable?
You cocky bastard.
There. What did I tell you? That passage there is gonna take us right under the museum.
You called it, all right. You need to have a little more faith in me, chum.
Okay. This one here is me.
All right, remember, that tower is our only way into the exhibit. But we can't even get close with those floodlights on.
We've gone over this.
Just make sure you cut the power by the time we reach the second courtyard.
The lights will be out. I'll have the van waiting at the rendezvous point. Just make sure you get your asses out of there in time.
Fair enough.
All right, enough chat. Let's do this.
Chloe. See you on the other side.
Looking forward to it.
You sure you know where you're going?
Don't I always?
Wow, he moves a lot faster when he doesn't have a giant hole in his stomach. Look at that.
Don't you love the way the water makes your jeans all squidgy? It's like the good old days, isn't it?
Yeah. When were those again? Oh, wait. This can't be right. We must have made a wrong turn somewhere. Hey. Now, what do you bet that will take us right into the boiler room? And from there, we're in. Yeah, in like Flynn, right?
What?
In like Flynn.
I don't get it.
Just give me a boost. Here it comes.
Thanks.
Almost there. You ready? No guts, no glory. Here we go. We're good.
Oh, this looks a lot like a boiler room.
It's a giant boiler room.
Well, you know those museums, they can get cold at night.
Just reach up there and grab the ladder.
Okay, here we are.
Yeah, I dropped it down for you.
All right. This is the way to the courtyard.
Well, we're not going this way. Not if you want to keep your skin.
All right. There's gotta be a shutoff valve around here somewhere.
See if you can find it, then.
So do you think that one of them is going to betray the others when we get the lamp? Or do you think something's going to go wrong in the process of trying to steal it?
I think something's going to go wrong in the process.
And then we're just going to stick together for a little bit.
I'm now thinking Flynn is actually going to be the nice guy.
And the girl is going to be the one.
Yeah, she's going to be the one
everything.
Who... Yeah, she's going to dick everyone over.
You just like that phrase.
I do.
Maybe it's going to be Drake that's going to do it. The other two. Oh. We're gonna think Drake's the hero. He's gonna betray them at the end.
Now there should be a door just around this corner. That's our access point. Once we're through, just stick to the plan. You got me?
Tell me you didn't miss this.
I'm here, aren't I?
I really should turn off the flashlight soon.
It's locked.
Good job I came prepared. I pick more than my nose, my friend.
Wait! There's an alarm. That's new since last time.
Great. Now what?
Well, I can disarm it if we can find the junction box.
It's gotta be around here somewhere.
So let's follow the wire to...
treasure.
Okay. Treasure's good. I was kind of hoping there'd be a junction box back there, but... yeah, It goes
around that way.
I kind of assumed that I'd be able to climb up and over there, but maybe it goes farther around.
It's right there.
No, that's a fire extinguisher. Yeah. There it is, though. See, game, why are you giving me hints? I found it. All on my own, too.
There. That ought to do it.
That was not very well hidden.
Shit. I got him. Night, sunshine.
Are we gonna hide the body?
Nope. You're gonna kick him around some, actually.
There's the tower. Yeah, but we can only get to it from the roof, and we can't get to the roof from here. We're gonna have to make our way to the next courtyard, through that gate over there. Well, let's do it. That balcony. We can climb the gate over here. Got it.
So apparently all of Drake's friends are master thieves.
Well, when you're a master thief, what kind of friends do you expect to have?
Yeah, you know, I guess you're right. You would want to have Master Thief friends.
Crap. I've got the other one.
Haklısın abi. Hiçbir şey olmuyor. Bazen o kadar canım sıkılıyor ki uyanık kalmakta zor.
Am I just supposed to break for it and punch them? That's what I'm gonna do. I'm breaking for it and punching them.
Come on, what are you waiting for?
15 dakikaya kadar bitiyor.
İşler nasıl bu aralar?
Bugün epey bir sessiz.
Okay, we're almost there.
I'll go right, you go left.
Although I guess we're not as worried about stealth anymore. Okay, I like how he has different animations for depending on how he approaches them. And we watch. And we'll see if Mr. Flynn is as impressive as we are. I'm gonna do it.
Lights out.
Oh, okay. I guess that was a stealthy takedown, but flying dropkick.
Okay. We should be able to lift this up. Sneak right under.
Whoa! Whoa! Not so fast. There's another alarm.
Ah, great.
You want to get this one? Wait here.
See, now that's a much better place for a junction box.
Okay, it's off. This courtyard to get onto the roof.
Okay, I'll just let you do all the ass kicking, all right?
Right.
Hey, Marco.
Head for the fountain.
I think you've been seen.
Damn
it. You are absolutely correct. I was seen.
Head for the fountain.
Oh, there's the guy right there. Several guys right there.
Those glow-in-the-dark white shirts were... Well, they helped me out. I wonder if they'd see me if I jumped over right here. I don't see how I could possibly get behind them, though. See, there's another three. This isn't gonna work. I'm gonna try it anyway, though.
Are they... Do they not see you?
Apparently not.
I don't think they see...
There we go. That's what them seeing me looks like.
Sleep tight. Crap.
So try running around to Flynn's side. Can you jump down there?
Maybe I'm approaching this wrong. Maybe the answer isn't.
Oh, there's a sparkly thing in the fountain. When did that guy get there?
Okay, but now that we know that there's a guy there, it's possible. That's stealthily, right? Okay, that was the right answer. They are paying these guys way too much.
Lights out.
Way, way, way too much. I don't even know how much they're getting paid, but even if they're working for free, it's too much.
Oh, you need to get that guy. He's radioing for help.
Damn it.
Yeah. If I'd been willing to kill him right away.
Orda.
And then that second guy has already seen me.
Head for the fountain.
But that's definitely the right direction and the right approach. I just need to wait a little bit longer.
Mm-hmm.
Senin burada olmaman lazım.
I don't know why he didn't want to stealth attack, but...
You weren't sneaking.
Yakaladım. Shit.
What do you mean rapid punching isn't a good substitute for stealth?
You were spotted.
Yes, but that doesn't mean it's going to call for help.
Yabancı, müze kapalı.
Aha, that time he is definitely going to call for help. Yeah. Maybe I should just leave those two guys alone. Or at least, maybe I should leave Fountain Man alone. Because if he continues to look
no,
that way...
No, I think you need to get him, though.
Yeah, but he is looking away from where we need to go.
Uzakta dur!
See?
Yeah, you're right. Fountain Man. Fountain Man needs to go.
Head for the fountain.
Fountain Man gets himself in place. Pillar Man gets punched first.
No, get him.
Damn it.
Because sometimes he goes around to the left, sometimes he goes around to the right.
Head for the fountain.
Okay, there's one.
Sleep tight.
There's two.
Uzakta dur.
Oh no.
Oh, I'm glad he finally did something.
We just gotta find a way up to that window.
Which window? There's a lot of bloody windows.
See, and we only had to knock out two-thirds of their security in order to get this far.
They're gonna notice the bodies, though.
Eventually, yes, but hopefully we will have reached the oil lamp before that happens. Oh, this looks like another fun setup.
Oh, crap. Now what?
It's time to tip the odds back in our favor.
Oh, that's brilliant. Guns? What are you thinking?
Relax, Gandhi. They're tranquilizer guns, totally non-lethal. Your conscience will remain unscathed.
As if he didn't kill hundreds and hundreds of people in the first game.
Right.
Okay.
Those were pirates, not bodyguards.
Lousy range, so we still have to get in close. You okay with that?
Know how to shoot a gun, genius.
Alright, let's take these guys out.
Bu kutulara bizim taşımamızı beklemiyorlar umarım. Bu bizim görevimiz değil ki. Bunlar ne ki zaten?
Eski sergiden kalan eşyalar.
Okay, I pick the guy on the right. See, completely unconcerned about their friends suddenly falling over. Now, I wonder if I shoot this guy, if he'll take out the other one.
Yep, looks like it.
Good.
We gotta get up to that walkway.
Which walkway are you talking about?
Okay, for something with wheels, this is very heavy.
This is the same walkway that I was trying to jump up onto. I just didn't have a cart to help me out.
That'll work. Now all we need is a horse.
Those rafters will get us onto the roof, if we can get up there.
Good thing one of us thought ahead, eh? All yours.
Where did he go? He's right there.
He's just standing right there expecting me to do something. I assumed the answer was...
He said all yours. All yours what?
The difficult jumping that he is refusing to do is all mine. Which would be fine if I knew which things I was supposed to difficultly jump on. Not these. Unless it is those supports in the middle. I'll try a second time. Okay, I definitely smacked into it. And it's not the door. This is totally the opposite side of the room, the one that he was expecting us on.
Hello!
It said, go up to the other side. I tried to go up to the other side, and it turns out, nope. Opposite side of the room to the one the game told us to go on.
Alright, I'm coming. I think I'm gonna take the elevator next time.
No treasure. All right, no, right out the window.
Oh.
All right, there's the tower.
Getting closer.
Appreciate that update, Captain Obvious.
You realize that he just pointed out where the large tower was. And then called the other guy Captain Obvious.
I probably don't need to shoot that guy.
Oh, I think there's a guy on the roof. Nope,
that's because I missed twice. I believe I greatly overestimated the range of those guns. So this time, I'm gonna go... Fine. That guy doesn't get shot today.
It's lucky all of their buildings are so interesting.
Yeah, this place doesn't look much like a normal museum, and it looks...
Come on!
I'm coming.
More like an extremely elaborate warehouse that they decided to put... Oh, thank you, Mr. Flynn.
You put on weight, mate. Me up there.
Oh, shit, that was close.
All right, no more donuts for you.
Donut Drake. No more donuts for you.
Donut Drake is going to return, I'm sure of it. And is this our second courtyard? No, this is...
Yeah.
Potential dead end.
Once again, you're up. I'm right behind you.
As always.
There's a guy above you.
Sweet dreams.
See, and he was worried about killing people.
Yeah,
and all of a sudden,
dead.
That guy is so dead. Okay, I'm just going to sit over here and feel guilty for a while. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see about the oil lamp and the second courtyard and all of the non-lethal takedowns that we can manage later. ¶¶